we stop procrastination due to fear of failure? So if you are someone with low self-esteem, chances are we do procrastinate because of fear of failure. So anyway, if you're new to me, I'm Shika and I run a self-love course called 14 Days of Self-Love. And that's where I will teach you how to create a brand new self-loving mindset within 14 days so that you can live life according to the way you want it. So if this sounds like something you might be interested in, you can just go to my website, shikaanwar.com, to find out more about it. So how do we stop procrastination due to fear of failure? So tip number one is to work in 1 hour intervals. So for me, I will set aside 1 hour for every task that I have to do. I have a planner which I plan out my days in. So for example, from 11:30 to 12:30, I will be recording this video, and maybe from 12:30 to 1:30, I'll be editing it. From 1:30 to 2:30, I'll be having a lunch break and so on. So this is how I plan my day in 1 hour intervals. And for me, this works for me because it helps me, or rather it stops me from being an overthinking person, and it prevents me from being a perfectionist when it comes to my work. Tip number two is to find out the real reason why we are procrastinating. So this is more of a mindset tip. Many of us do procrastinate because we are scared of a fear of failure, and we are scared of failing because we feel as though, if you are a perfectionist, you feel as though failing or making mistakes lowers your value as a person. And or maybe because we set unrealistic standards on ourselves. So in order for us to overcome this, what we can do is to be kinder to ourselves and to bear in mind that everybody has an off day at times and everybody makes mistakes. And nobody is expecting us to be perfect. You know, only we are expecting ourselves to be perfect. Okay, so for you, if you want a worksheet to help you out with that, you can go to one of my blog posts. I will link it below. And you can download a worksheet or read the article there to help you overcome your perfectionistic tendencies. So tip number three is to tackle the most difficult tasks first. So for most of us, we have a limited amount of energy every single day. So this works for us because at the start of the day is when we have the most motivation and the most energy. So what we can do is we set a time and a time limit to complete this task. So for example, I will do this difficult task from 11 to 12 p.m. and we try to stick to it as much as we can. So this works because it gives us a sense of urgency. So that's tip number three. Tip number four is to work during your best working time. So what does this mean? Okay, everybody's best working time is different. So for me, my best working time is from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. So this is the time where I'll be doing work which requires a lot of thinking and strategizing, because that's when I'll be the most motivated and full of energy. And for the rest of the day, I will do something relaxing. For example, reading a book to upgrade myself, or creating an Instagram post, or creating blog pictures and all of that, all of those stuff. So for the rest of the day, I will be doing more relaxing things, but during that peak working time or my best working time, I'll be doing the work which requires a lot of energy and thinking. Tip number five is to shift our mindset about failure. So if you are a perfectionist, you might think that making mistakes actually lowers your value as a person, even though that is not true. So if we have that mindset, then all the successful people are low worth because they make a lot of mistakes. So because people whom we call successful are people who make even more mistakes than the average person does. So you can see how flawed this thinking is. And people who are what we call successful, like I mentioned, make a lot of mistakes. And whenever we make mistakes, we can think of ourselves as getting one step closer to perfecting our craft and one step closer to improving our work. And if we don't make mistakes, we don't learn. You know, it's very tempting for us to avoid opportunities or to avoid new ventures and projects because we are scared of failing and embarrassing ourselves. And it feels much nicer to be in our comfort zones. But actually, when we try something new, even though we might embarrass ourselves and we might flop at times, it's actually more exciting than staying in our comfort zones. And we grow so much more from trying something new. And when we shift our mindset and lighten up a little bit, we can afford to be more playful in life. So having said that, maybe you have not read my blog post, which is called 3 Actions to Overcome Perfectionism. I will link it below for you to read. And there is a worksheet with that. There's a cheat sheet to help you to feel calmer when you're faced with a lot of perfectionistic thoughts. So you can go to that blog post and download the worksheet if you want to. It's linked down below. Okay, see you in my next video. Bye.